I'm Ellen Savard, Senior Manager of STEM Experience for Girl Scouts of Connecticut. That means I get to do things like Lego robotics, rocketry, astronomy, lots of engineering, and I feel like I have a really great job. So I want to welcome you from around the country and maybe even from around the world. Here is where I am in the U.S. So I'm in Connecticut, which is this star way up north in the Northeast. In fact, Connecticut is so small that this star completely covers the state. And this is what Connecticut looks like in a bigger format. And this is where I am, down in Southern Connecticut in a town called Easton. So how close or far are you from Connecticut? Today, we're going to work on the Junior Cybersecurity Basics badge with a special activity called Roll with Protocols. We'll learn about protocols and how computers use protocols to send and receive information. And then we'll play a game to create our own protocols. This activity will take about 15 minutes, and these are the materials you'll need. You'll need two dice, a sheet of paper, and a pen or pencil. And give yourself enough space to turn around in, because we'll be moving around a little bit. Protocols are important in everyday life. A protocol is a set of rules that says exactly how something should be done. When computers share data, they follow a set of rules or protocols. This makes it easier and safer for the computers to share information. The set of rules is like a language. For example, the protocol might be include a rule that says, talk only when it is your turn, or do not talk when anyone else is talking. These are rules, but they don't have to be done in any particular order. You may have learned about algorithms, maybe from another Girl Scout badge. Algorithms are a series of steps that accomplish a task. These steps have to be done in order. It's like following a recipe. It wouldn't make sense for you to frost your cupcake before you bake it, right? So, let's stay in the kitchen for a minute. The algorithm or recipe for making cupcakes might be: first, mix the ingredients. Then, pour the batter in the pan. Then, bake it in the oven. Make your frosting. Frost your cupcakes. And then eat them. So those all have to be done in order, right? But when the recipe tells us to add 1 cup of flour, we know that doesn't mean a coffee cup or a plastic cup. We know that it means use an 8-ounce measuring cup and level it off. That's the rule. So when you know that you have to put together a cup of flour, you spoon your flour into the cup and level it off. That's the way you always do it for any recipe. So that's a rule. So the protocol is the rule, and the algorithm tells us the steps to use to get something done. Some people use these two terms interchangeably, but now you know the difference. So let's be computer programmers and create a protocol that others can use following a pair of dice, using a pair of dice. And we'll get up and moving in the process. You ready? So first, you're going to assign protocols to each number on the die. So it's six-sided. So you're going to need a set of 6 protocols, one for each number. So you could do this by creating a list of 6 rules. So here are the 6 rules that I assign to my die. 1, spin around 3 times. So if I rolled a 1, I'd get up and spin around 3 times. 2, do 5 jumping jacks. 3, jump into the air. 4, do your favorite dance move. 5, clap your hands 5 times fast. And 6, raise your hands above your head and wiggle your fingers.
So let's try.
I'm gonna roll my die. And I got a 5 and a 6. So that means I'm going to clap my hands 5 times fast and raise them above my head and wiggle my fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So as you develop your protocol, you write your list of rules and the assigned numbers on the sheet of paper. So you have that sheet of paper in front of you, number 1 through 6, and then assign 6 different actions. If you wrote the protocol above that I did, someone would roll their die and have to follow the protocol or rule you assigned to that number. For example, if they roll a 1 and the protocol for 1 is spin around 3 times, that's exactly what they'd have to do. Once you have your set of protocols, invite your family, your siblings, any adults that are around to take turns rolling the dice and following the protocol assigned to that number or to those numbers. After you've had someone test your protocols, give them another chance to roll the dice. However, this time, they can choose to follow a protocol or not. They may want to do something different or do nothing at all. Afterwards, talk about how the 2 rounds felt. So the first round, remember, was when they are following your list of protocols. The second round was when they could or they didn't have to. How did your family feel when they had to follow a protocol they didn't feel like doing? How did they feel when they had the choice to follow the rules or not follow the rules? Then you can brainstorm more about protocols. Ask yourself, why do you think protocols are important in computers? Where else do you see or use protocols in everyday life? I bet you can come up with a couple. When else might protocols be useful? Now that you're all done, let's ask a few and answer a few questions. Well, I'll ask them, you answer. What did you find enjoyable? What did you find challenging? Did you struggle with anything? What might you do differently next time? And most importantly, what might you like to learn more about? So I did a next time for myself. And this was all about eating, because that is something I love to do. So I assigned 6 actions to my 6-sided die, right? So whatever I roll, I'm gonna have to eat. So the first one is pickle. 2, ketchup. 3, peanut butter. 4, cracker. 5, fruit. And my fruit of choice is raspberry. 6, vegetable. It could be any vegetable. For me, maybe a carrot. So I'm going to roll my die. And I got a 2 and a 5. So not sure about this, but I'm going to have to eat my raspberry with ketchup. What do you think about that? Let's try it again. This time I rolled a 3 and a 4. Peanut butter on cracker. Much better. So now that we're all done, what did you learn? What is a protocol? What is an algorithm? Are they the same thing? Or can you explain the difference to your friends? If you liked this activity, look for other fun activities on Girl Scouts at Home. Visit the Girl Scout shop at girlscouts.org for more ideas, or reach out to your local Girl Scout council or troop leader. Thank you for watching this video and trying the activity. Hope to see you next time.